I would suggest you put the gun away, Monsieur Castillo. Aren't you in enough trouble already?
This is breaking and entering.
I have a mission to accomplish. I won't rest until it's done.
You know, Cruz and Eden are going to be back here any minute. Mason.
I thought it only proper that Adriana get a hand-delivered invitation to the wedding.
You're sweet. But we're still going to get arrested, you know, but it was worth it.
Yeah, I don't want to seem strange, but does this room feel different somehow?
I kind of always dreaded coming up here until now, but now...
What?
Well, it's kind of like the house knew that Cruz and Eden were bringing Adriana home. Well, all right. It was just a thought.
Let's get out of here.
Like Christmas, huh?
Hey, take that back. It's better than Christmas.
What did you do? Buy one of everything?
Look, that's the least of it. I got another load in the car.
You don't think you've overdone this a little?
Oh, no. Get the swing set coming in the morning.
The swing set?
Yeah, they were going to be here by 6, but the truck was out somewhere, so they couldn't swing it.
We're in good spirits, aren't we?
I don't think I've ever felt this good since I don't know when. Maybe when Eden was brought home from the hospital. Maybe when Kelly was brought home from the hospital. Maybe...
I get the idea. You're absolutely incorrigible.
Uh-huh.
I mean, you get excited about something, you get all emotional, then you feel like you have to lavish everyone with gifts.
Well, yes, I am absolutely, totally materialistic. But I do have other ways of showing my expressions. I really do.
What is that?
This way.
Oh,
she's coming home! Yes!
You're not supposed to be doing this.
Dad? I just talked to the pilot on the private jet. They're going to be here in about 10 minutes.
We're flying over the house.
We're almost home, darling.
I've come back to Santa Barbara so many times, but it's never meant this much.
Do you realize it's almost 5 years now since you first came back from Europe?
That was a different person. Thought I knew all the answers. When I met you and learned all about love and compassion and commitment.
Well, that's a two-way street, and I think this little one here is going to teach us a few more lessons. And I'm not talking about those 3 a.m. seminars on patience and understanding either.
Oh, look, sweetheart. We're almost home.
The investigation into your smuggling activities has been suspended at the request of Inspector Castillo. I can offer you no protection against the syndicate. You have 48 hours to leave France. If you don't comply under your own power, you will be escorted to the airport. Do you understand?
I have business and financial holdings here in France. You can't expect me to leave within 48 hours.
Your wife had holdings in this country.
Monsieur, I represent the family of your late wife.
They've hired a lawyer to fight her will.
There is nothing to fight. Your wife's will was read at 7 this morning.
Why wasn't I notified?
Well, the bequest of the will didn't justify your presence.
This townhouse, the country home, and all assets and accounts of your wife's were left to the Beaulieu family. Of course, you can keep what you brought into this marriage.
Which, of course, amounts to 2 Armani suits and a watch of doubtful authenticity.
That's it?
Your wife did leave this letter for you.
Cece bought a whole stuffed zoo for Adriana.
I'd say he's pretty much got all the species covered.
Have you seen him today?
No, he's been out running around, buying out toy stores.
I've never seen him so excited.
I can't blame him. It's a big day for the whole family.
Yes, for all of us.
What do you mean?
What do I mean? What do you mean? Megan hasn't told you.
Hasn't told me what?
Hello, sweetheart. Oh, good. Good to see you.
Mm. Hi, baby.
Hi, honey. I am so proud of you.
Oh, I didn't do anything.
Oh, don't play modest with us. We heard all about how you helped get Adriana back.
Yeah, she said she'd never be able to manage it without you.
There you go.
Well, at least she didn't mention all the things I screwed up.
Where's Cruz and Eden?
Oh, they decided to take Adriana right home.
Ah, okay. Well, let's get over there. Come on.
Wait a minute. There's probably maybe a reason. They took the baby home, and maybe they want to have some privacy or a little time.
Well, privacy from us? Come on.
Well, no, wait a minute. She's got a good point here. We can be kind of a pushy group sometimes.
Well, what are we supposed to do? Sit around here and wait for a phone call from them or what?
No, I think we should give them a little time, and then we'll go over.
Yeah, I think you're right.
Yeah.
Bet she's really grown, hasn't she?
Oh, she has.
Really?
And she is so beautiful. I think she must look just like Eden when she was a little baby.
Oh. That's all the time we're giving them. Let's go.
Yes, yeah, I need you to. You help me with the toys. Come here.
I'll take them.
Yeah. Oh, we're going over to see Eden Cruz. They just got back. The baby's over there. We're going to see it. Look, Rupert's coming for dinner. I know I told you 8 o'clock. I'll be a few minutes late. Start without me. It's a great day.
Well, he certainly seems to be walking on air.
So is the whole family. All of us.
Us?
Or so says Sophia. What exactly did you tell her?
It has been almost a month since we left home.
Yeah. It's been longer than that since this place felt like a home.
Well, Adriana, you didn't realize you were going to be so well-traveled, did you? But now you're home. You're going to stay here for a long time. This must all be so strange to her.
I don't know. Look at her.
Yeah, well, she does seem pretty right at home.
Yeah, well, I guess she knows there's nothing to be frightened of now.
Do you realize I haven't stopped holding her since we left Paris
this
morning?
Well, I wasn't going to say anything, but now that you've admitted it, could I touch her once? Would you mind if
I... Well, I don't know. I think I need to talk to her for a second. Do you want to go to
your
father?
Wait till she can speak for herself? Now, let me just hold on to her here.
Mm-hmm.
Come on.
I think her eyes say yes.
Okay. Hi, sweetie. Goodness gracious. Can you tell me there's no such thing as a miracle?
I tell you, for as many times as I wanted to believe it was going to happen, there were times when I really didn't think we were going to get her back.
I know, I just meant that, well, you and I did what we did, and look, we got this human being out of the deal.
I know. Sweetheart, you want your father to show you around?
I think that's a yes. Well, let's start with your nursery, shall we, darling?
Right this way, you're going to love it. Come on, it's as high as the cloud.
You see, sweetheart? This is your room. It's been
waiting for you to fill it up for a long time. It looks like you've already had a visitor there.
Who would have been in here?
I don't know. What's it say?
The presence of Miss Adriana Castillo is requested on Friday, June 2nd, when Julia Wainwright and Mason Capwell will be united in marriage.
Wow, fancy that, sweetheart. Haven't been back in town a few minutes, and you're already the queen of the social scene. What do you think?
Mason, you're so crazy.
For marrying Julia, or for inviting Adriana to the wedding?
For breaking into our house to leave its invitation.
Well, I gave him the key. I didn't realize he'd put it to such nefarious use.
A homecoming and now a wedding? I don't think it gets any better than this.
Well, I think a hug might jack it up a notch, yeah?
I don't want to leave this house from either one of you ever again. I had to tell Sophia the truth. She gave me no choice.
I don't understand. You
Ray,
promised.
She hired a detective, and she found out that your father, well, that Joe Hughes died in Vietnam 3 years before you were even born. She was ready to start pushing it, and I could not let her be the person to tell Cece the truth.
What makes you think she won't tell him now?
She promised me she would.
I don't care what the lady promised. Mom, what do you, makes you think she'll keep it to herself? She flew all the way to New Hampshire, pretended that she worked for Princeton, and then she couldn't wait to run back and tell Cece that I was your son. What makes you think that she'll keep a bombshell like this to herself?
Because she has nothing to gain and a lot to lose by telling him. And she did give me her word. Now, whatever I may or may not think about Sophia, I do think she's a woman of her word.
I'm not so sure.
Greg, whatever differences I have with Sophia, they don't have anything to do with you. The fact that she knows you're Cece's son doesn't change anything.
It does. You said I could come here to get to know Cece Capwell, observe him without any strings attached. Well, how am I supposed to do that when Sophia knows I'm his son?
I'm sorry it happened this way, but it doesn't have to change the way you feel about Cece.
I don't know. This is all blown out of proportion. It's not just that Cece's my father. I'm an uncle. I have all these other relatives now, too. I have two nieces. I don't even know how I'm supposed to feel about this.
You're not supposed to feel any particular way. Oh, God, I thought you were starting to like some of the people in the family.
It's not about whether I like them.
Yes, it is. That's an important part of it. I mean, even in the short time you've been with him, you must have seen how much love there is in this family.
That's part of what makes it so difficult. Sometimes I wish you wouldn't have even told me all this.
I'm sorry. I am so sorry. I know this is upsetting and it's confusing, but I don't...
You don't understand. Mom, it doesn't matter what I decide. I'll never be a part of the love this family shares for each other. Why would I think they would want me? And why would I want to mess them up any more than you already have?
Greg. No. How did you come to an ordeal like that and still look so good?
Yeah, really. Every hangnail or sleepless night winds up etched in my face for days to come.
Well, I feel relieved. I guess it shows.
It certainly does.
Where is my daughter and my granddaughter? I mean, I've got a house full of booty here for my granddaughter.
See, I don't want you spoiling her.
Oh, then you better put the cuffs on me now, because, you might as well arrest me. I'm going to spoil her to death. Now,
and
come on.
He will, too.
Yeah, Samantha's proof of that. We're going to have to build on another room just to accommodate all the toys and stuffed animals we've given.
Yeah, you know, why didn't you ever spoil me that way, Dad?
Oh, poor little Ted. Only got stuck with 3 bicycles and 4 electric trains and all those remote-control airplanes.
All right, we get the point. I wasn't that spoiled.
Excuse me. What you didn't answer my question.
Well, it's hard to get a word in edgewise with the Capwell clan around.
Especially when they're excited about something.
Yeah.
The only way you're going to shut us up is if you let us see that little baby. Is she in the nursery?
Picking out something appropriate to wear, no doubt.
Well, yes. Actually, Eden put her down for a nap.
Oh, she's taking a nap.
Nap?
Yeah. She's taking... Why didn't you say something? Wouldn't we be making such a racket?
How wouldn't wake her up?
She's slept through this invasion. She can sleep through anything.
Did she get any sleep at all on the plane? She must be exhausted.
No, you don't have to whisper. She didn't get any sleep on the plane, and I'm sure she's out like a light.
Oh, okay. Well, I'll just tiptoe up to the nursery and take a look inside.
Mr. C, if it's all the same, I think that Sophia should get the first look at her.
Oh.
should go and we should let her sleep. We should go back to sleep.
I'm not going to leave your side for a minute. You know, besides, I read in the books that you should continue your normal activity, you know, and talk and everything. You should be able to fall asleep anyway. Besides, when she does fall asleep, she's a very sound sleeper. You know everything about her already, don't you? I tell you, Mom, it's so strange. All the months we were apart, and then when we were together, it seemed like we were always together. The moment I held her in Paris, I knew she was Adriana.
I had the same bond with you when you were a baby. Only you were not the sound sleeper.
Well, did I cry a lot?
No, you didn't cry. Of course you didn't cry. But I remember when I tiptoed into your room just to cover you with a blanket or just to watch you sleep. Your little eyes would pop right open and then you'd get this mischievous little grin on your face. You just wanted to play.
Mm-hmm.
I remember one night I stood there for an hour and watched you play. You had a little mobile over your crib. It had little ducks on it, little rabbits, and I just loved it.
Mama, I cannot believe you remember all of that.
Well, of course I do. I remember everything about when you were a baby. I think that's kind of one of the magic things about being parents. You remember all the events, all the little moments. Oh, you're going to have to relish every moment you have with Adriana. Watch all the changes. Watch every little step. Because children grow up so fast. And then pretty soon they're having babies of their own. Proud of you. You never gave up hope. Somehow you endured through everything. And it all paid off.
More than anything, Mama, I hope I can be as good a mother to Adriana as you were to me.
I would advise you to get rid of that gun. You would also be wise to accept the escort to the airport.
Hey, you guys are taking the furniture now?
Not for a few days. You've made a wise decision not to fight any of this.
There's not anything left to fight for. I lost everything when my wife died and my brother took my baby. The rest of this stuff are just things. Can't believe I'm even saying that. That sounds like something that would come out of Cruz's mouth.
Your brother pushed very hard to ensure we didn't prosecute you. I would advise you
I am sick and tired of your advice, okay? I got the message about leaving France. I'm not fighting this slimy lawyer over the will, so why don't you just leave me the hell alone?
My men will be watching this house and the airport. Be on a flight leaving this country, Monsieur Castillo, within 48 hours.
Hey! And what about my wife's funeral? Huh? I called the mortuary. They won't even tell me where it is.
The family is not disclosing that information.
They don't even want me at my own wife's funeral, huh?
And I wouldn't recommend you pursuing it. You will not be let in.
Daddy, stop pacing. You're going to get a chance.
I don't know why your mother had to go first. She could have at least flipped a coin. All right, it's my turn.
No, my turn. No. Wait a minute.
I've waited a lot longer than a minute.
Oh,
that's terrific.
Thanks.
Well, that way we can hear her no matter where we are.
Oh, yeah, I could rig up a video camera so you can watch it all the time.
Oh, yeah.
Has she grown?
Not that bad. Grown. She's big and beautiful.
It looks like Eden?
Looks like Eden. Looks like Cruz. The perfect combination of both her parents. Juice okay?
Oh, sure.
Yeah, let me know. Thanks.
Well, I can't think of an event that calls for a little celebration more than this one.
Celebration. Let's celebrate with fireworks is what I'd celebrate with.
I think they had something a little less ostentatious in mind, Dad.
Well, it's no secret there hasn't been much to feel good about around here lately, and, to tell the truth, I don't think I would have gotten through this period except for my wife. Truly, her strength and her faith have been unflagging. She simply refused to give up, which seems to be an attribute she holds in common with the rest of you people. I really think you all had a part in making this dream come true, and I just want to say so. God must have overheard our prayers when he was busy listening to yours. So from the bottom of my heart, thank you, and thank him for helping bring our little girl home.
Here, here. You got them all.
Now, I think maybe we should leave this family alone before we completely wear out our welcome.
I don't leave this house until I see my granddaughter.
Oh,
she's waking up.
Do you think maybe we could just take a peek at her now?
I think so.
No, I'm hurt.
Well, do you suppose they'll give us visitation rights?
I don't know.
Won't you play the music so the cradle can rock?
Is it a dream when they sleep, honey?
This age, gosh, beats me.
You mean that being back with the mother and father?
You can tell the Sandman is on his way. By the way that they play, as still as the trill of the thrush in a twilight. As you sail away.
Right on that way, I feel like a slave to the beauty and the power of my...
What do you think? I wouldn't give up your day job.
What do you know about surf music?
You mean somebody actually likes that junk?
Me.
How about a hit?
Go ahead. Hey, watch the slop back.
Oh, that's really foul.
Hey, yeah, excuse me for forcing it down your throat there, you know.
You actually like the taste of this stuff?
Hey, surf wine, we run it through a cow first.
Surf wine, surf music, isn't there anything in your life that doesn't have to do with the surf?
Yeah, you, so why don't you stop hogging this wave and go home?
Yeah, I'm sorry, I just came down here to get away from everything.
Yeah, you and everybody else. I mean, look at those waves, all those white caps out there on the moon. It's like everybody here is equal, dude. I mean, money don't matter. Families don't matter. I mean, it's like, if you want to escape, this is like the ultimate. Yeah! The ultimate. The ultimate refuge.
Whoa. What? Can I see your guitar for a second? I think it needs to be tuned.
You know something about music?
Tell me.
Gentle voice echoes into the night. Say, don't be afraid of the dark. Don't be afraid of the dark.
Hey, this stuff stays. It's mine. Personal
what
stuff.
Is all
hey,
of
this is mine.
going to a funeral.
Well, it's the chapel. It's very quaint, and I think you're going to love it.
Oh, I'm sure we will. I am a little embarrassed, though, that you put off your wedding because of us.
Well, it wasn't only because of you. Your father was in the hospital.
What? You were in the hospital?
I'm fine. I'm fine. I had a very, very mild heart attack.
A heart attack?
Will you relax? I am fine now. The doctor has me on an exercise regimen. Your mother has the finest chef cooking the healthiest meals in the world. I mean, look at me. Would you ever suspect I had a heart attack? I'm as fit as a fiddle. A cello. Would you believe an oboe?
Daddy, this is not funny.
Honey.
Mama, is he really all right?
Doctor said that there wasn't any damage to the heart, and if he takes it easy, yeah, he's going to be all right.
You see?
Why didn't you tell us?
I didn't know where you were. What would you like me to do, shoot flares up in Paris?
I think you could have at least left a message at the Paris office.
I know, wait a second. Take it easy, honey. We didn't want you to worry, all right? Everything's all right.
It certainly is. Dad's healthy. You've got Adriana back. Julie and I are getting married. As far as I'm concerned, everything's right with the world.
Attaboy.
I can't very well have a wedding without my matron.
Well, I'm glad you didn't, because I am very excited about this wedding.
Been a long time coming.
Speaking of time, maybe we should get out of here.
Grace, trying to think.
Rot gut's not going to make it any easier, you know. Winos use this stuff to preserve their livers.
Give me a break. I only had a couple of swallows. I can't take the taste of this stuff.
Sorry, I'm just a little insensitive where drinking is involved.
No problem. How's Eden and the baby?
Great. Beautiful kid.
I can imagine. Well, listen, I'll see you around, Mason.
Greg, is there something else wrong?
I understand you used to be the black sheep of the family.
Yeah, until all too recently.
Felt like you were the on the outside looking in?
Yeah, way outside, like from another planet.
For no fault of your own.
Well, I wouldn't exactly say that, but it felt like that most of the time. Why?
It's a lousy way to live, isn't it?
You know, this has to rank up there with one of the best days I've ever had.
Not to mention one of the most exhausting. I think maybe we ought to skip that dinner you planned.
No, we don't have to do that. I promise you a late meal. We're going to have...
do it one night when you're not so worn out.
I just haven't caught up in all these things that are going on with the family. I also promised you that I would get you more involved in it, too.
All right. I don't expect you to force me on your family. Especially when there are a couple of your children who are not big fans of mine.
Mm.
I think it might be better if I stay in the background until they have a chance to get to know me better.
It might take a lot longer than you think with my kids. They're going to get their hackles up when someone tries to become part of the family permanently. I seem to remember... when I first married Sophia, how difficult it was for Mason to adjust to my new wife. Wow. Getting a little ahead of myself, aren't I?
I think you're getting ahead of both of us.
You know, I thought when Greg came to town that you'd relax a little more. You sure it's only the family that's bothering you?
Sorry, it's just not easy to feel like an outsider looking in.
Not to be that way, you know. You know what I just said about having a new wife didn't seem all that terrifying, now, did it?
Speak for yourself.
All right, I will speak for myself. The thought of us getting married felt comfortable.
See, I don't think this is a conversation we should be having tonight.
You know, Cindy, I don't think this is a conversation we should be having tonight. Come and get some sleep.
Get some rest. We can talk in the morning. Good night.
Good night.
But you're not ready for bed. You could no more go to sleep right now than I could.
Is Sophia, do
me... Now, you may think Megan is the perfect woman for you. But no one in the world will ever know you like I do. Still thinking about Rick?
Yeah. Just can't get over it, you know? Comes storming back into his life, and I turn around, and he's lost his wife, and lost his child. It's amazing.
Rick brought it all on himself. You are not responsible for what happened.
Well, I might not be responsible for what Hollis did, but I practically raised Rick. I was the only father figure he ever had, for all the good it did him, you know? It's hard not to feel that I'm not some other man.
No. No. Rick was just too young to handle his father running out on him.
How could any man run out on his family? I mean, what would be working in his heart that would allow him to do that?
Cruz, we have our own family now. That's what's most important, don't you think?
Yeah.
My wife is in that box. I have a right to be here.
The woman's family gave me instruction.
Get the hell out of here. My dearest Rick, by now you know the truth about Charisse. She's not our baby. But I love her as only a mother could love her own child. So I'm taking her and going away. You will never see us again. I'm sorry, but I know this is for the best. You never loved me. I was devastated when I first realized that. But then I understood you don't have the capacity to love anyone. I wanted so badly to make our marriage work in spite of that. Maybe someday you will learn to love. Only then will you truly understand what I felt for you.
All right. Why did you come back here?
I don't know. I don't know. I felt today and tonight that we were really more of a family than we've ever been. Really. I mean, we've been through a lot of stuff together. We've been to weddings and funerals and crises of all kinds. But today was the happiness, all the happiness.
I know. I felt it too. Like part of a victory, incredible victory.
And I guess the reason I came here is that, after all the excitement, you know, I thought about going back to the hotel alone, and it felt very lonely. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, I know what you mean. Mm. Big house, being here by myself, makes me feel lonely, too.
Yeah. Well, it sounded like Megan, you know, kept you company or something.
Not exactly the right person to share this with.
Am I?
Sophia, we have three children. Nothing can ever break that bond.
I think somebody already has. This was a mistake.
No, not really anymore. It sort of feels like the family's complete tonight. As if all the clouds that lowered upon our house are in the deep bosom of the ocean buried.
Funny, I look out there. Wish I could trust that. I see more storms waiting to roll in.
Well, they say to balance things out, the good outweighs the bad. If that's true, then I figure we have about 73 years, 4 months, and 12 days of good coming to us before any more bad comes along.
Was the Adriana beautiful?
Yep.
It was great to see them all together.
It sure was.
Made me want to have another baby.
You're not serious.
No. I'd like to see you do this with your eyebrows. But if we do, I'd like to have another girl. A little beach bunny.
I know just the chick.
Sit down.
Thank you, God, for my family. Thank you for letting us be together and be happy again.
Yes, I'm still here. Castillo. Rick Castillo. Final destination? Santa Barbara, California.
A world superpower in crisis. An army of student demonstrators challenge the pillar of Chinese power. And NBC News is there, showing you the tense standoff and gathering reaction from around the world. Watch the crisis in China unfold on NBC Nightly News with Tom Brokaw. And later tonight, Surf's Up. Catch a tidal wave of excitement in Irwin Allen's blockbuster movie, Earth's Final Fury, starring Paul Newman, Jacqueline Bisset, and William Holden, tonight only on NBC.